buildings with multiple stories, right? That's not necessarily something we encounter outside of an urban area. So we need to really watch out for that. And also underground basement levels or even subway systems, which technically we don't deal with too much here. Maybe we will in the future. Who knows? But when we think about an urbanized area, like, these are all factors that you really need to think about when we're entering them. All right, who is the point man of your element?
Best man for the job, sir.
Best man for the fucking job, that's right. So they are the one that is going to dictate the pace and what's going on, and you need to have trust and faith in them to be able to do that shit. Otherwise, this is going to fall apart real quick. So make sure whoever you have on point is the one for the job, and they know what they're doing so that you can trust in what they're doing, and y'all guys will be fucking swinging dicks through this in no time. Make sure we're always keeping 360 security. If we ever have to stop for any reason, make sure you always have 360 security. There's always alleyways, back streets, whatever. The enemy knows this locale way better than we do, so they are able to maneuver on us from any direction, from any sight line. So you really need to keep your 360 up. And also pulling security at danger crossings, so any large sort of street crossing or even like a big alleyway, make sure you're checking it at least. Maybe you don't have to set up a full danger crossing at every single one, but everyone that passes it should be, you know, turning and looking, pointing their weapon in that direction just to scan it really quick to make sure there's no one out there. What else should we do that Captain Tell's favorite thing on the planet is if we're in a mountain environment?
Hand throwables.
Holy shit. So, especially in urban environments, frag grenades, use them. If you're confident there are no civilians and you know there's an enemy in the room, frag grenade is fine. The explosion is not going to, you know, damage too much. It is what it is. Your job is to kill the enemy, especially in a mount environment. This is more of a military operation than a civilian consideration, but we want to try and hold 40 mics because those are a little bit more destructive. But if you need to switch out a frag or something to have an extra flashbang or drop a yellow smoke to grab an extra flashbang, so be it. And lastly, always remember to have your weapon pointing where you're looking, also known as combat pace. So with our new stamina, we need to be really careful of this because moving like that will really drain you, right? So you need to be careful and cognizant, and this goes back to communicating with each other and working with your point man so that everyone can move together as one element to get through this alive. All right, that's going to wrap up the quick talkie talk portion. Any questions before we step off? Sergeant Yeager.
Thank you, sir. I think somebody slipped a magazine into your pistol while you weren't paying attention, sir.
That's okay. I'm an officer now. I'm allowed to have a loaded sidearm.
Copy that, sir.
Thanks for asking, though. All right. Captain, do you have anything?
Negative.
First Sergeant, do you have anything?
Negative, Chris.
Okay. Havoc 1, do you have anything?
No, sir.
All right. Let's lock and load and mount them up.
Cool.
Hey, O'Connor.
Can't mount them up.
One, this is one thing, or are they still counting after this?
Acronym, et cetera, et cetera.
Oh, the kit bag?
Who said that?
One, one, this is 3-2. Diamond, or,
Microphone activated.
Thunder, this is Echo 7.
Dagger, this is Thunder. Send it.
You are cleared to lift and get ISR on our LZ.
Copy, cleared to lift. We'll be spooling engines in 15-0. Airbus 1, Airbus Thunder 6-3, Slingon 7-5, 1 times 810, Thunderbolt 2 at 810 parking. We'll be spooling engines. Our responder is Thunder 6-3, good spool on both engines. We'll be taking active runway...
I guess this might be good spool.
0-9er for immediate takeoff. Thunder 6-1 is rolling, active runway 0-9er. Just a little bumpy, just a little bumpy. Oh, that's a big bump. Oh, there goes the water. Like you said it would. Airbus Winter Center 6-3, sending us 7-5 out to your east. Good day. Son of a bitch.
Can you fight this dagger on 7-0?
It happens right on that one.
Air
all
collector.
In your critter spool and lift.
Channel switched.
tracking my bird again. Well, another bird again, as the other one probably is destroyed somewhere out in the water. Anyway, spilling engines. First one is Thunder 6-3, sending a 5 on two spooling engines. Exiting onto active runway 09er, media takeoff. Rolling active runway 09er.
You're in the wrong room.
Dagger, this is Thunder on 70. Sorry, I'm on comp now.
Tango Mike Thunder. Thunder, send your cast second when ready.
Dagger, this is Thunder. I'm 1x810 Charlie, Thunderbolt 2, call sign Thunder 6-1. I am currently full on the Gao, 1,350 rounds in total. 6 EGM, 65 Hotel Mavericks, 2 times M9 X-ray Sidewinders, 6 times Mark 82 general purpose bombs, 1 Mark 82 air burst. I am DCS, laser, backache capable, sitting by with a port code of cold on 704.
Dagger reads back, full on the gun, 6 times Hotel Maverick, 6 times Mark 82s, 1 time airburst, 2 times sidewinders, with their board goes cold.
Further, I forgot to give you 2 times GB49s.
Warlord, lifting, heading out to the north.
Dagger, this is Warlord. 3-2 on 7-0.
Warlord, this is Dagger, because of Charlie on 7-0.
Roger, stand by for cash check-in.
Dagger, standing by.
Departing the airbase time now, climbing 4,000 feet. Call sign is going to be Warlord 3-2. Full on the gun. 4 kilos, 4 Limas, 32 Hydras, 2 Sidewinders, DCS, and laser capable. Fuel is 99%, leading time on station 0 plus 120 minutes, port code of linebacker.
There, copy. 4 times kilos, 4 times Limas, 3-2 times Hydras, fall the con, 2 times Sidewinders. Port code of the linebacker.
Dagger, correction on the Hydras, it was 3-8 Hydras. I recall the other readback was correct.
Dagger, copy correction, 4 times 2 is 4 times minimum, 3-8 times Hydras.
Copy, Warlord is standing by on 7-0.
All stations standby for sit rep. Be advised, we have contact being initiated by Havoc 4 on TRP India, which we have identified as a fortified compound. We have contact time now. Break. We are expecting 4-5 positions in between phase line 1 and 2, and any outlier fortification to be dealt with via air. Stand by for work on 7-0. Should have something for you soon.
Air Race, this is Willard. Out to the north, signing on 7-5.
Quarter pit.
Dagger, this is Warlord. On 7-0.
Send for Dagger on 7-0.
Extreme north of the map, there's an armor piece, red 4 mark 1349 in that compound up there. There's two times armor pieces up there. One of them just went active and is repositioning in that compound. I'm going to mark it when you come stationary.
Dagger copies two times armor pieces within TRP, and you have one time currently active.
Master 1-2, we are spilling at Hill Parking, and we'll be lifting and Fitzman Sierra departing directly to the east. Oh, correction. Direct to the green. Show Lancer early.
Warlord, stand by for a 5 line.
In traffic for Warlord again.
Will be type 2 control, requested 1 times CELO, friendly break. 1.4 clicks to the south, looking at 1 times MBT near TRP India, requesting no remarks, no restrictions.
Roger, type 2 control requesting 1 times CELO on BMP at or around TRP India. Is that on my lights?
The NBT, record marker 1350, you mark as active.
Roger. Eyes on.
You are cleared hot.
This is Warlord. That target is catastrophic.
Dagger copy. Thunder. Priority ISR requesting a DEA for Havoc 4's last fire mission.
And to clarify, Dagger, we didn't kill that, somebody else did.
Solid copy.
Dagger, this is Thunder. Where was their fire mission at?
Standby, Thunder, will advise.
Dagger, this is 1-2 on 7-0, ready for domestic.
Standby, Lancer. Thunder, this is Dagger on 7-0. Be advised, they are shooting at TRP India.
Copy, TRP India.
The UCAN is on the rooftop of the palace where that tank just got blew up at.
Yep, affirm, there's also a mortar pit.
Lanta, this is Dagger on 7-0.
Once we're ready to send cash check in, you ready to receive, over?
That's an affirm.
Fair 1 times, Alpha Hotel, 6 Mike, designate Lancer 1-2. We are currently at IP South at roughly Tariff 5. We are 95% bleeding with flight time of 60 plus Mike. We are DCS and laser spot capable. We are 2600 full on the gun, 2 kilos, 19 hydras, and with a board code of Pip-Boy. Say again, Pip-Boy.
Dare copy, 2 times kilos, 19 times hydras, with a board code of Pip-Boy.
Good read back, Dagger. Lancer 1-2 out. Standing by for work.
Dagger, this is Thunder on 7-0.
Send for Dagger on 7-0.
I'm pretty sure I saw one of those rounds land directly on top of that big green cargo tower.
Everything should have been wiped off the top of it, but it's still standing. There's two times EGS systems and two times static AFTs. With another infantry up there, they should have all been wiped out.
Dagger copy, standby.
So for some reason, all the birds I've gotten in today have their collision lights already on.
Ground crew was being extremely effective for once.
Yeah, but the batteries, man, they gotta replace parts. I feel bad for them now.
Hey, if just as long as you notated to the engineer or the mechanics that you were not the one that left the battery on, and you signed out, and you signed out after the battery was on, they'll figure it out.
Roger.
Thunder, this is Dagger on 70.
Send it.
Is that second MBC still in TRP India somewhere?
That's affirmative. It is still in its location. Are you going to have Havoc 4 do another repeat fire mission?
That's a negative. They're currently on the move.
Copy. There's three ZU cannons with another mortar pit in the northwest corner of that COP, as well as AGS systems on top of that bickering tower, marking up the MBT if it's not already marked up. It was, but I resituated the mark.
Lancer, this is Warlord Solo. Are there rearm repair trucks and all that stuff at the airbase compact, or what's there basically?
I'm gonna take a look right now, Lancer.
Yeah, I just figured it'd be easier if they're there, but if they're not, they're not.
Nope, there are rearm repair as well as resupply boxes for vehicle as well as infantry.
Got it, but the birds aren't there, so that's that.
Yep, birds aren't there, and it doesn't look like I have any birds there either.
Oh, that's fine. At least we know we can land closer now if we have to.
Yeah, roger that. Right below us.
What do you got going on right below you?
No, he was just answering, I think, about where that was.
Gotcha.
Thunder and Warlord, have you seen anything more aggressive anti-air-wise than the ZSUs, or the ZUs?
That's what I've seen.
Thunder, this is Dagger on 70.
Dagger, this is Thunder, send it.
I'm seeing a lot of emplacements in Fort Kufra to the west of the town. Can I get some more specifics on what's there?
Sagan?
To the west of the town, there is a little fort marked, labeled Fort Kufra with five marks of static emplacements on it. Looking for more details near Tier P Bravo.
Oh, copy. Yeah. It's a it's three AGO systems on top of a building, and that's a mortar pit directly next to it.
Solid copy. Interrogative, are they still all still active?
They should be in. Did you guys hit them with that before?
I don't believe we did. All right, Tango Mike. Tiger out.
We keep hearing explosions. I'm guessing that's a passenger fire from the area. Just keep that in mind when you're down there.
Dagger, there's
yeah, right, that we've been hearing it too.
Stand by for 9-line.